Shutting down the quarry is completely absurd. That quarry is the lifeblood of this town. Why the hell is Dewey allowing this to go through? Why isn't he fighting it? Hmm? I just realized I've been ranting to a complete stranger. Wait, aren't you that swordsman who rescued my son? Sorry, I've just been thinking about the situation in the quarry a lot lately. Ever since they closed it, the Countsmen have been seen going in and out like they own the place. It's aggravating. That quarry is far too important to this town and everyone in it, at any rate. I hear you wiped out all the monsters down there. Even if you're not from Redmont, you're a true friend to this town. Here, I've got something for you. I hope my son grows a spine like yours one of these days.
Closed, I'll never get my hands on any Ravel ore. I don't look forward to the mountains of death that await me when I get back to Run.
But wait!
You're the type that people randomly send on quests, aren't you? If you can find me just enough to keep my backers from breaking my kneecaps, I'll buy it from you at top gold! What do you think? I swear, I'll pay handsomely.
Chester. Adol. I'm sorry. I've just got a lot on my mind. My brother gave me this pendant. He left it here in a letter for me. On the day he vanished. I guess it makes me feel closer to him when I wear it. But in reality, he was closer than I ever realized all this time. I'm so sorry, Adol. So many horrible rumors have been going around about my brother. And then, to hear the man who raised me confirm them all? I just want to know what's happening and why. He must have a reason, right? Maybe I'm being selfish. I should just be grateful he's alive. In a way, it's like a weight I've been carrying for the last 6 months has been lifted from me. I may not know what's going through his mind just yet, but I do know that if I could talk to him, just talk to him, then things might go back to normal. So, don't worry about me. But thank you for your concern, Adol. I really do appreciate it.
This has become quite serious indeed. Why would Father Pierre go to such a place?
Please, forgive me. I should have tried harder to stop him.
My, my. Such blazing red hair. You must be Adol. I've heard murmurings about you amongst the townsfolk. My name is Nicholas. I am head of the Felghana Diocese. I was also the town's priest until 3 years ago. Now I serve at the castle, while Father Pierre enlightens the town. I still drop by from time to time, though. Old habits do die hard, as they say. I fear, however, that my visit today may be a bit less transient than usual. Are you familiar with the Ilburn's ruins to the northeast of here? They are the remnants of a temple used by practitioners of a pagan religion from a long-lost era. It would seem that Father Pierre has taken it upon himself to visit that temple for purposes unknown.
It's unsafe in every regard. And popular rumor suggests the place is infested with monsters of all shapes and sizes.
All the more reason for concern. One cannot help but fear the worst. Adol. Adol Christen, they say you're the one who rescued Mayor Edgar from the quarry. given your considerable skill, might I humbly request you undertake another such mission to find Father Pierre? Such selfless courage. On behalf of the Church, you have my deepest gratitude. I believe you will be needing this. The Ilburn's ruins are just off the road, to the northeast of here. This key opens the access gate. Please, do whatever you can to ensure the safety of Father Pierre. May God be with you. Fight well, adventurer.
Welcome. Thank you. Thank you. Don't be a stranger. Welcome. Don't be a stranger.
Thank you. Thank you.
What are you doing here?
I could just as easily ask you that same question, Father Pierre. This is not a fit place for the likes of you. If you value your life, I suggest you leave at once.
Chester, you should at least let Elena know what you're doing, and that you're okay. She's been worried sick. She's never stopped looking for you. After all this time, not once has she lost hope.
That's no concern of yours, Father. Keep sticking your nose where it doesn't belong, and it's liable to get cut off. Well, well. Seems these ruins have a little rat problem.
Adolf?
I warned you not to get involved. But since you seem incapable of following orders, you leave me little choice. So, you're not all talk. You actually have some skill, which means I needn't go easy on you.
Stop this, both of you!
I'd advise you to stand aside, holy man. Let's see what you're made of.
Men, seize them!
Well, if it isn't Lord Maguire, may I ask what brings you to such a place, my lord?
What brings me? Why, I merely thought I might come to worship at the seat of my future power. And what should I find when I get here but my top knight dealing with intruders? So, tell me, who are these people?
The clergyman is Redmont's head priest, and the swordsman with the red hair is the latest adventurer to cross these lands.
Oh, an adventurer, you say? A meddlesome priest is bad enough, but an adventurer simply won't do it all. I imagine he hopes to get his hands on my statues. No matter. We will dispose of him here.
If that is your will, my lord, I know of a place nearby that is most suitable for meeting out a man's final judgment. I believe you'll find it quite to your liking.
Will I now? Very well then, take me there at once.
As you wish.
Precipice high above the lava pits. Wait. This should make quick work of him. All right. Do it.
If you'd simply minded your own business as I would, this wouldn't be necessary. But now, your fate is sealed.
Could you? God will never forgive this sinful behavior.
You certainly do like to prattle on, Father. Take him to the dungeon. Chester, you're doing well. I leave the rest in your capable hands.
You honor me, my lord. I shall find the statue here without fail.
Jaws of hell itself shall consume you.